such a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming up, and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children to jump the very best you can, the world won't get no better if we just let it be. Na 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 na. The world won't get no better. We gotta change it now.
Hysier, the book is called No Place Like Home. We have unfinished business. You can go to DelGrecoWilson.com. Check out his site. Again, shout out to Del. The Black Cager and Black Cager Publications. I've ordered my copy. It's $25. It's money well spent. And again, beyond basketball, there is a mission behind the book. It takes a lot to wrap our heads around gun violence, the gun violence epidemic. It's plaguing Philadelphia. It's plaguing the whole country. And it's a complex situation with no easy fixes. And again, for you as a college sophomore, take this on really speaks to your emotional maturity. Can you talk to us about how the book came together and what inspired it?
I was just, you know, thinking about just myself and my journey, how I got here, just all the things that I had to overcome. And more importantly, just thinking about where we're at in the city of Philadelphia, because the gun violence thing is, it's not like just in the streets anymore. It's like it's carrying over to the basketball court.
Yeah,
I mean, it's carrying over to the schools. It's having a bigger impact than just affecting the people that's in the streets. So I feel like it's a major problem that should be addressed. And like I said earlier in the podcast, I got a platform to some capacity. And I feel like if I can continue to grow my platform, and maybe this message could be seen by more people in the basketball world, in the basketball community, and not just in Philadelphia and other major cities that's experienced with similar problems. Basketball is something we all gather around, so just using that platform to kind of push this message, because it got to come to a point where we got to make a change, because there's too many kids that's coming behind us that's not necessarily even dying, that's just going down the wrong paths. We got to find ways to, you know, bring solutions, bring things in front of these kids so they can have outlets. Because, I mean, if you're accustomed to seeing one thing all the time and you don't have no change, you're gonna do what you say. So I feel like the book is tells my story, but it also tells some of my experiences, because, you know, I'm just not talking about it. Like, I experienced some of these things with friends, family. Like, I can name 30 people that I know, like, that I've been here that's not here anymore. So just those experiences alone is devastating, but you got life comes at you fast, so you got to keep going and you got to deal with it. But it's not a normal thing. And like, sometimes in Philadelphia, I mean, we try to normalize it. Like, a lot of people I know, like, I mean, you wake up, somebody gets shot.
Yeah.
They just go on about their day, but it's not supposed to be that way.
No. Well, an incredible amount of credit goes to you for putting the book together. I'm really looking forward to reading it. Again, I'm going to encourage everybody to pick up a copy. Speaking of the book, Del shared an excerpt from it. And getting back to basketball, you, of course, were one of the players who entered the transfer portal once Aaron McKee and Temple parted ways. And you were honest about the fact that you had options. Other programs offered you better NIL deals, cost of attendance stipends. Before we get to why you decided to stay, tell us what it was like out there in the portal. Like, who was recruiting you, if you're open to sharing? What was it like out there?
I got a lot of offers from various schools, A-10, American, got some Big East looks, just a numerous amount of schools. But the most important piece for me is just wanting to be somewhere where I felt comfortable. I mean, I had came across a lot of good coaches in the transfer portal that just was honest, I felt like. But it was just something about me making a decision before Temple made a decision. Like, I knew that I wanted to wait and see who they hired. And I mean, you know, they go and tell you different things when you're in the transfer portal, X amount of money, X amount of minutes, and what they got going on. But more importantly, you got to, you know, go how you feel and make decisions for you. So I feel like after talking to Coach Fisher, like in 45 minutes to an hour after thinking about it, it was kind of like a no-brainer.
No, we got to change it now, just you and me. Wake up all the doctors, make the old people well. They're the ones who suffer and who catch all the hair. But they don't have so very long before their judgment day. So won't you make them them happy before they pass away. Wake up all the builders, time to build a new land. I know we